Alright folks, today we are making stuffed and grilled cabbage rolls, so stay tuned. It's time to grill. Let's get started with heating up the infrared cooking zone of my Landman Triton gas grill. We are using a grill grate and a pot of water. Bring the water to a boil and in the meantime you can prepare your cabbage rolls. This is a German cabbage. Of course, there are several different cabbage versions available wherever you live. It doesn't matter as long as it's fresh cabbage. I guess I took between 12 and 15, and this is way enough for today's recipe. I saw a lot of cabbage roll videos in the past, and cabbage rolls are known to a lot of parts in the whole wide world. People are doing this quite different. I like to do a little bit of a mixture of what my grandma does with the different seasoning, but I will tell you more about that later. As soon as you're ready with the leaves, put the leaves into the hot water and let them sit there about 1 or 2 minutes. They should start to get soft too. Make sure not to overcook them at that point. They still should be stable enough to keep the meat stuffing inside we are preparing later. Okay, I will put in a second one. I guess you know how to do this. That's pretty easy, but it might take some preparation time. Once you're ready with pre-cooking the cabbage leaves, take a sharp knife and cut a little bit away of that hard inside. They are now soft enough to be stuffed. Set them aside and let them cool down a little bit. And then we are ready to prepare the stuffing for our cabbage rolls. Take away the pot with the water and start to heat up a cast iron pan. We don't need that high heat anymore, so take down a little bit of that heat, add some olive oil. Normally I like to show you cutting action, but today I didn't. We have already prepared diced onions. Let the onions sit in that pan and keep on stirring for 3 or 4 minutes. And after 3 till 4 minutes, add the already prepared diced garlic. Now give it a good mix and let that sit in that pan again for another 4 or 5 minutes. The garlic will now starts to smell good and the onions will start to get soft. Now take your seasoning. We are using Pul Biber, which is a chili seasoning, paprika, which is hot paprika, cumin and dried oregano. And now the smell is awesome. You have to keep on stirring, you have to keep the heat, and you will now have a great, great smell of that seasoning with the onions and the garlic. Of course, you have to keep on stirring, otherwise it might burn. Of course, nobody wants that. As soon as the color is good, take it off. Let it cool down a little bit and we can prepare the meat stuffing. You will need ground beef, ground pork, same seasonings within the onions, dried oregano, Pul Biber, paprika, cumin, additionally mustard, soy sauce, and the onion mix. Now give it a good mix. Everything should be together. And after giving it a mix, make sure to give it a taste and see if it tastes good. For me, there was something missing, so I added salt and pepper. Final mix again, and then we are ready to stuff the cabbage rolls. Looks good enough to eat though. I usually take one of those leaves and approximately a huge tablespoon of that ground meat. Start with the side and then turn over. Roll it over again and again. Keep on doing this with the other leaves. The stuffing was good enough for about 10 till 12 of these rolls. Those cabbage roll can be cooked in a Dutch oven as well. I decided to do it differently this way. We are putting them into a larger bowl. You all have seen this bowl several times in my videos. It's one of my most important tools. And then we're adding a slight sauce topping for the cabbage roll, which is different to what I do usually. You will need tomato sauce, red wine, dried oregano again, balsamic vinegar, Worcester sauce. And that's it. Mix it and pour this over your cabbage rolls. In addition, I also added a huge dash of red wine, but I haven't filmed that. You will see that later when we take out the cabbage rolls again. I have already prepared my Landmann Triton gas grill, 140 degrees Celsius, this is approximately 284 degrees Fahrenheit, indirect heat in the middle, and let that grill there for 30 till 35 minutes. And here is the result. Doesn't look that spectacular from that point of view, but it's getting better and better. Now take a knife and then we see how the cabbage rolls look from inside. And they are so juicy. Can you see the juices running out? It's so cool and it's awesome. I love it. It's a little bit spicy, but this is how I want it. And it's so juicy. You can see it and I bet you could smell that already. Okay, of course, as always, I'm gonna give this a shot right now. Please let me know how you do your cabbage rolls in the comments. We are seeing us again in the upcoming days. I'm really impressed by that recipe idea. Anyway, thanks for watching. I'm out. See you.